hey everybody, welcome to this edition of The Hot Seat. And today we have Liz Swaine, who's the Executive Director of Downtown Development Authority for Shreveport. Hello, and thank you so much for being on with us today.
Oh, I am really excited to be here. Thanks so much for asking.
Well, we are excited too. And at home, they are so excited to talk to you. There is so much going on downtown Shreveport.
I know. Well, the theme is excitement. So let's just stay excited about everything going on in downtown Shreveport.
There we go.
It really is remarkable. Are you from here, Crystal?
Yes. Yeah, I'm actually from Shreveport, you guys. So.
Okay. You're pretty young, so you do not remember how it used to be. You're very young. Let me rephrase.
Oh, thanks.
But apparently the heyday of downtown was between like 1900 to let's say 1960s.
Wow.
And that's where people lived. They worked, they played, they shopped. It was really the only place around here to shop, to do all of that.
Okay. Wow.
Every single business was packed. Every single block of downtown town had multiple businesses. I mean, it really was the place where everybody came for every reason. Mm-hmm. And then the interstate came through in the late 1950s. Mm-hmm. Businesses started moving farther and farther out of town, so the residential started following all those businesses, and downtowns across the country sort of went into a really sharp and rapid decline. Downtown Shreveport, no different.
Wow.
But the last 5 to 6 years, boy, have we seen a resurgence. Mm-hmm. People are living downtown. Mm-hmm. People are working downtown. People are shopping downtown. And boy, are people having fun downtown.
Now, talk about shopping.
Yes.
November 25th, that was Small Business Saturday. Tell me about how did that go for you?
For those who don't know, American Express started Small Business Saturday a number of years ago. And the reason they did it is because small businesses, which are really the lifeblood of our economy, both locally and across the country, didn't get a lot of love and attention.
Right.
It's kind of a shame that we have one day a year that we talk about small businesses. We should be talking about them 365, right? But
right.
at least we've got the one.
Right.
So what
right.
we do is we focus on the fact that our small businesses, which are local businesses, are what make us unique. Mm-hmm. They make us different. You know, when you go to Dallas, Houston, Fort Worth, name the city, everybody's got a Walmart, right?
Right, of
everybody's
course.
Everybody's got a Sam's. Mm-hmm. Everybody's got a Home Depot. Everybody's got the big box stores.
Right.
But how many people have the Robinson Film Center, the Abbey Singers, the Herbie K's, these cute, unique, individual places that really give you your sense of place and your sense of home? I can't tell you the last time I went on a trip and I wrote to all of my friends and said, hey, I can't wait to tell you about the wonderful experience I had at the Waffle House.
Right.
It's always about the wonderful experience you have at the little hole in the wall.
Mm-hmm.
Or the place where there's only one of in the entire world and you went there.
Right. Yeah.
So that's why we need to cherish and love our small businesses, because if we don't, they'll go away.
Exactly. And if you're like me, I mean, I hate going to those big stores during the holidays because it's so packed. You just want to go somewhere local and shop. And tell me about what we have downtown Shreveport. What are some of the stores?
Well, we've got a really nice cross-section. We've got a lot of art-related industry downtown. Art has really become economic development.
Yes.
People love to be around it. They love to own it. They love to participate in it. They love to be around artists because they're very creative, bohemian, you know, avant-garde people.
And that's in style right now. So
it's super in style.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Mm-hmm. So we've got the Agora Borealis, which is an art marketplace, and Norsworthy Gallery, and Art Space, and Artipsy, and a place called Bonton Coffee Shop, which really has an artistic component to it, because one night's a poetry night, one night's a music night, one night's an art live night. So they're really playing up on all of that.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a few retail spaces. We have a couple of great places where you can buy men's clothes and women's shoes and gifts and
awesome
restaurants and we've got adult places, so nightclubs and places where you can dance and go have fun.
Wow.
But we really would like to see more of that retail component come to downtown, and slowly we are seeing it.
Also new restaurants popping up as well.
Yes,
excited about that. Love to eat. So
restaurants are fun because let's just be honest, we eat at least 3 times a day.
Yes.
Some of us eat a few times more.
Yes, yeah.
And so restaurants know that at least a couple of times a day you're going to be hungry and you're going to be looking for something to eat. So we do. We've got restaurants that range from fancy hamburgers to seafood to Mexican to we've even got an Asian place downtown that's a great little Asian called Bon Asian.
Wow.
We've got some South of the Border inspired coming. We've got another seafood restaurant coming in the Red River District.
Mm-hmm.
We've got several others that are kind of just floating around looking for places to land. And we're hoping that we can find the perfect location for them.
Well, you know, you are in the hot seat, Liz.
Okay. Whoa, it's feeling warm.
Yeah, it is actually warm. So what are some of your favorite places to visit downtown?
I've got to say that I have a special love for a place called Robinson Film Center.
Right.
It's a very small movie center. Mm-hmm. It's just got two screens.
Right.
It's teeny tiny. You feel like Cheers, like that bar on the TV show where you walk in and everybody knows your name.
Right.
Because you just feel comfortable there. Everything is familiar to you. Mm-hmm. You see movies there that you may never see anyplace else. They're small movies. They may be foreign movies. They may be art house movies. They're not the big screen. You're not going to see The Return of the Jedi, you know, or something
right.
like that there.
Exactly. Yeah.
But you may see a movie that you've never heard of that will quickly become the best movie you've ever seen, and you won't be able to forget it. And they have this wonderful little restaurant right upstairs called Abby Singer's, where you can sit out on the balcony, you can look down beautiful Texas Street, somebody will bring you the most wonderful drink and food, and you can just chill, and it's an experience really unlike anything else.
Wow.
So I've got to say, of all the places downtown, that's the one that keeps calling my name.
Mm-hmm. Wow, that sounds really good.
It does.
Awesome, awesome. Now tell me about, did we talk about Small Business Saturday, and how did that go for people in our area, or if it's, is it not too late to, you know, patronize those the restaurants and clothing stores still?
Never too late. Mm-hmm. Never too late. You know, I love to tell people that if you happen to miss Small Business Saturday, if you were hungover from Black Friday, if you just couldn't do
with
anything
all the turkey,
more, I know, and all the shopping.
Yeah,
and,
we
are still there. You know, these businesses do 30 to 40% of their business between Thanksgiving and Christmas.
Right.
30 to 40% for the year. Mm-hmm. So I encourage people, please come downtown between now and Christmas. Go to these shops that maybe you haven't been in years, mm-hmm. or maybe you've never been in.
Yeah.
Come experience them. See what we have to offer. Mm-hmm. And while you're doing it, support these families who live here. And these are families who are the ones that you go to when you need a sponsorship at your school or for your little league team. These are the families who participate in activities at your church. These are the people you know. Mm-hmm. Let's support the people we know.
And that's so important, to actually pour money back into where we live. That's very important.
It is.
Yeah.
No one else is going to do that. I am not telling people not to shop online, because everybody's going to do it, and they should. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you will find the absolute perfect thing that you can't find anywhere else. Mm-hmm. You will find the thing at the price that you can't find anywhere else, and I get that.
Right.
And it's easy. Mm-hmm. You can do it. Boom. All your money's gone. You know, you've got a house full of stuff that you'll never use. But those are not people you will ever meet. Mm-hmm. They will never give you a donation for your church or your civic club.
Right.
They will probably never be available to you on the phone if you have a problem. And think about our small businesses. You can walk in, you can ask to see the owner, you will see them right then, mm-hmm. they can resolve whatever issue you're having, you will have made a friend for life. Mm-hmm. It's night and day different.
Yeah, community effort.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is information I'm sure people at home would like to know. Like, again, downtown Shreveport is looking different.
Mm-hmm.
There's lights in the mornings or at night. You guys have lights up. What else can we expect to see in 2018, or just what's going on right now in projects?
I would love for people, and speaking of lights, it made me think of how beautiful our riverfront looks.
Yes.
Around the mm-hmm. new Shreveport Aquarium. So gorgeous. Mm-hmm. If you love seeing holiday festive lights, please bring the family, drive through, put on some Christmas music. Mm-hmm. It will really put you in the Christmas spirit. Go up Texas Street. All the wreaths are lit. I mean, it's just a magical looking place in the evening, so come through. Mm-hmm. But things that we can see in 2018, well, the Shreveport Aquarium.
Yes, yes, I'm glad you
mentioned
that.
And doing well. Yeah. I don't know if you've had the chance to go yet. If you haven't, that's another one of those things to put on the list of things to do.
To do, okay.
It really, they have put so much neat stuff into a small space, and kids love it, adults love it. I've heard nothing but rave reviews, so please go by that. Mm-hmm. We've had several developers, again, who are looking at different projects downtown. Mm-hmm. We've got a couple of historic buildings that have been vacant for years, mm-hmm. that have not done well. The roofs have caved in. You know, we were very concerned that the long-term future for them would not be good, but they are in the process of being purchased for things like apartments and retail. Very excited about that.
Yes,
we've got
exactly.
restaurants that mm-hmm. are coming in online for 2018. So a lot of things happening.
I'm very excited about that.
Yeah.
All right. Well, Liz, you stay right there in the hot
seat. I will.
Don't run away. Mm-hmm. And you at home will be right back after this commercial break. Stay with us.
cup?
Not exactly.
Since 1985, J&S Electronics has served the architects with superior electronics from transistors, resistors, and fuses. We carry HDMI cables and a wide selection of AV cables and connectors. We also have a large supply of batteries and tools to handle your projects. Need Cat 6 or CCTV systems? Call us at 318-631-8675 or come see us today at 6437 Greenwood Road.
Special times or dinner time. It's all about the glass. Libby Factory Outlet, glasses for every occasion.
Take off your dress. When I was in Moscow, I heard about a program. Young officers trained to seduce and manipulate. To use their bodies. To use everything. Call them sparrows. That's what she is.
Since 1985, J&S Electronics has served the architects with superior electronics from transistors, resistors, and fuses. We carry HDMI cables and a wide selection of AV cables and connectors. We also have a large supply of batteries and tools to handle your projects. Need Cat 6 or CCTV systems? Call us at 318-631-8675 or come see us today at 6437 Greenwood Road.
All right, thank you guys so much for staying with us. And if you are just joining us, we have Liz Swaine, who's the Executive Director of Downtown Development Authority for Shreveport. Thank you for not running off.
I don't know, the seat got a little hot, but I'm still here.
You are in the hot seat.
That's right.
All right, well, I love historic buildings and just kind of looking at what was, as you were talking about with the 1950s.
Yes.
Talk about just some of those, restoring the whole old historic buildings downtown.
Our building has such an authenticity because so many of the buildings have been there for 100 plus years.
Yeah.
The stories that they have to tell. There's a great TV show that used to be on called If Walls Could Talk.
Interesting.
If walls could talk, yeah. Boy, there's no telling what we might hear downtown.
Exactly.
Everything from illegal red light district to actual mayors dueling in the street, shooting at each other.
Wow.
It was a rowdy, rough and ready kind of place.
Yes.
So many great tales to tell. So many of those buildings still exist. One of the buildings that's being rehabbed, Howard Hughes, used to be seen walking up and down in front of that building.
Wow.
Other buildings, when you start pulling away the boards and doing the rehab, you'll find evidence of their past lives. Mm-hmm. You'll find old coins, old money, unfortunately no gold.
Yeah.
I mean, we have been looking for that. Okay. So these buildings, though, in a lot of cases have been sitting vacant or nearly vacant for a number of years, and the developers are taking on a project that is risky.
Right.
Because you don't know exactly what you're getting into.
And expensive.
Expensive.
Right.
Old buildings, rehabbing them correctly can be very, very expensive. They're not up to code. You've got to redo everything. Electrical, plumbing, air conditioning, heating, everything. Roof, windows, you name it.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the things that has made redoing historic buildings make dollars and cents is this thing called the Historic Tax Credit.
Okay.
We have two of them. We have one at the state level, which is a good tax credit, and every year when the legislature's in session, we have to go down and fight for it, but
right.
So far, so good.
Okay.
The other one's a federal historic tax credit. And at the federal level, right now, of course, Congress is all involved with tax reform.
Right.
So one of the things that may happen is we may lose the federal tax credit. I'm very worried about that because we have three historic projects right now that I'm afraid if we lose that federal credit, these projects will stop. And that we will not be able to save those buildings.
Now, when will you know if you get that tax credit or not?
As soon as Congress makes a decision. Right now, on the Senate side, the tax credit is saved. It's intact.
Okay.
On the House side, they've done away with the credit. So now they have to go to what's called a conference committee, and they have to hammer it out amongst themselves and figure it out. So we are sitting on pins and needles, literally.
Special times. Or dinner time. It's all about the glass. Libby Factory Outlet, glasses for every occasion.
Sway in the morning, Shay 45. We gotta talk about what's happening in Chicago. Hey.
Everybody's watching this viral video. This guy in the hoodie, they're calling him the Grim Reaper. He stopped a carjacking.
Is he right for taking the law into his own hands?
He's become a folk hero.
What about the shooter?
He looked like a white dude.
I love my family. But when they needed me most.
911, what is your emergency?
These men, they're breaking into my house. I think they're here.
No.
I failed to protect them.
Dad, where's Mom?
The men who did it are out there.
So there's nothing that you can do? Is that what you're saying?
If a man really wants to protect what's his,
I want to buy a gun.
He has to do it for himself.
We're closed, pal.
You killed my wife!
Who else was there?
I don't know anything else.
I believe you, Joe.
You're not gonna kill me.
No. Jack is.
You got caught in some crossfire?
The ice cream man done it.
The ice cream man?
Can't walk to school if you don't work for him.
Who are you?
The last customer.
You're not a cop!
Somebody has to do it!
You're cocked, locked, and ready to rock.
I'll say.
They called him a guardian angel.
He saved my life.
You look much better getting out, socializing.
Not so much.
Well, whatever you're doing, keep it up.
Okay, I will.
Since 1985, J&S Electronics has served the architects with superior electronics from transistors, resistors, and fuses. We carry HDMI cables and a wide selection of AV cables and connectors. We also have a large supply of batteries and tools to handle your projects. Need Cat 6 or CCTV systems? Call us at 318-631-8675 or come see us today at 6437 Greenwood Road.
Machines don't have emotions, but the rare few can inspire them. The first ever Lexus LC. Experience amazing.
Maybe why I feel hot.
Right.
Because I don't know what's going on. Well, hey, this is the hot seat, so there
That's
you go.
That's right.
Yeah. So, I mean, Shreveport downtown is looking so different. There's a Family Dollar right down the street from us.
That's
I mean,
right.
There's people living downtown, mm-hmm. and as you said, we haven't had that in so long.
We haven't. We've got the new lofts at 624, the old Sears building in the 600 block of Texas, okay. A beautiful building. It's got a Rhino Coffee, it's got a Seasoned Salon, it's mm-hmm. got a number of really wonderful office spaces in there, everything from website to a photographer. So that is doing really well. We've got another building that's going to be called The Standard, which is an old bank building wow. at Market in Texas, which mm-hmm. is being rehabbed for apartments. They're calling it The Standard because it will be the standard to which everything else will be judged.
Wow.
That's how much confidence they
wow.
have in that building.
Okay.
And that should be ready to move into by October or November of 2018. Very exciting.
Okay, so mark your calendars.
Mark the calendar.
Sounds good. Yeah.
We even got condos that are being built downtown in the 700 block of Marshall Street
wow.
called Ridgeway Square. These condos are going to be beautiful. I just was walking through the
wow.
construction site yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
So all over downtown we have open concept, historic buildings, brick walls, big thick plank wood floors, you know, all the kinds of things that people love so much now are all under construction for them.
Right here downtown Shreveport.
That's it.
You're doing a good job.
Thank you.
Awesome. So talk about some of the upcoming events going on.
Holy moly.
Yeah, I know there's lots, but like for December for shopping,
I know.
So yeah.
Absolutely. We've got so many things, but we do something called an e-blast that goes out every Thursday, and what we try to do mm-hmm. is guide people to our calendar on downtownshreveport.com,
okay.
which is the listing of all the events going on, and literally, there are more events than you have time, money, or patience for. I will tell you that.
Wow.
But you can choose the ones that you like the most, mm-hmm. so go to the calendar and look.
And we'll definitely
but,
have a link to that on,
oh,
on our
you.
Facebook page, so check it out.
Thank you.
So, yeah.
And then downtown, now through the end of December, we have this thing at Art Space called Holidays, D-A-Z-E,
okay.
because you're in such a daze around the holiday period. There's so much to do.
Yeah.
It is an art market filled with wonderful artists, make and take crafts. Every Thursday they're having this thing called Tablescapes, where you can see some wonderful artists do an incredible holiday table that you can replicate at your house, so all your friends and family will be amazed at how wonderful
wow.
and crafty you are.
Now how much is that? Do you?
That is free.
Okay.
You can go to Holidays and you can watch the Tablescapes for absolutely free. You can get tips from the artists. If you decide you want to buy something, that's great, but you don't have to.
That's wonderful.
But just remember, if you do buy something, they're all small and local art vendors, and so we're helping our local economy there.
Mm-hmm.
The Robinson Film Center has a number of wonderful events for this whole month.
Wow.
Elf the Movie, where you can go and have lunch with Buddy the Elf and watch the movie. There are book club events. There are things going on down at the Shree Memorial Library. There
mm-hmm.
are things going on in the Red River District. Every Saturday they have something going on.
Wow.
They have movies outside. A special, you're going to see Santa everywhere. I don't know how Santa has time to do all the toys
yeah.
at
he's
the North
busy.
Pole because
yeah.
he's down in Shreveport
yeah.
every day.
Yeah.
So I don't
that's
know
awesome.
How that works.
Yeah. Wow, that's pretty
yeah.
cool. Yeah. So again, what is y'all's website to get that information about?
It's downtownshreveport.com, mm-hmm. and we have two Facebook pages. We have Shreveport DDA okay. and Downtown Shreveport, and we try to cross-promote on all of those. Mm-hmm. And if you have any question that you cannot find the answer to, you can always call us or email us. You can call us at 222-7403
okay.
or email us at dda@downtownshreveport.com.
Why is it so important to shop downtown for the holiday?
Well, downtown is the place where it all started. It's where our history started. It's where our city started. It's where I would love to see you come and shop. If you haven't been downtown in the last few years, I encourage you to come down to see all the different changes, to enjoy the holiday season, and to support our small and local businesses.
Thank you so much for being on the hot seat. And
thank you.
Anything else you'd like to get out there, just definitely to shop local this Christmas.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. I would like to encourage people to do that. I would also like to encourage people to support our downtown. It's where we got our start. Yeah. It's what gives us our attitude and our personality. And we need all the support that you can give us, because it takes all of us to make an incredible downtown.
All right, and we love our community. So.
Yes, we do.
All right, well, Liz Swaine, we thank you so much for being on the hot seat. I hope you guys enjoyed at home, and we'll see you back here next week. Have a good day.